being in love with a girl who was coming to London, and Cordelia and Lucy were like, oh, maybe it's you, Cordelia, like maybe like James is in love with you. And then she realizes like, no, James is in love with Grace. It just happened that they were both like about the same age coming to London at the same time. And she's kind of crushed inside, but she's gonna keep it buried down deep. She gets a letter from Charlotte and it says like, hey, your father held the mortal sword. He literally can't remember what happened, which is gonna make the trial a lot more difficult. The kiddos decide to trap the manticore. That's what we find out the demon is, a manticore. And it's like this thing that can duplicate itself and become huge and unbeatable. So they're gonna put it in a pyxis, which is essentially like the bottle of a genie. If they suck up the main one into the pyxis, all the other ones kind of follow. And I love Anna's reaction to this plan. She's like, why are you doing this? How did you decide on this plan? And why in Raziel's name haven't you told anyone else about it? Because we are guessing. Oh my gosh. Side note, Anna is like, oh, like, yes, like, this is my like, list of lovers. And she's like, oh, Virginia, a very promising writer. Are you talking about Virginia Woolf? Oh my gosh, James walks Cordelia home. And Cordelia's mother is ecstatic to see Cordelia with James because he's like a very eligible young bachelor. He'd be great for her to marry. He's in a powerful family, like reputable, and she's just so excited. And Cordelia's like, oh my gosh, mom, no, no. Her mom keeps trying to invite him in for tea, and James is doing a great job of flattering her. He's like, I remember the dishes you had, they were so great. And Cordelia's like, okay, mom, James gotta go. And then like pretty much almost immediately after, all these beautiful dresses arrive to Cordelia's residence. And they're from Anna because Anna like held up that fabric to her and she like knew all this stuff about fashion. But Sona, Cordelia's mom, thinks they're from James. And Cordelia's like, we're just gonna let her think it. Then we find out that Oliver died because like in her last moments, Barbara had like crunched her nails into Oliver's skin, which gave him the poison. And now he's dead, which was really upsetting. So now it's time to go get the pixies to distract all the people in the Hell Royale. Cordelia does this super saucy dance in one of these new gorgeous dresses Anna Lightwood got for her. And she like does this sort of like, she performs like with her sword in tune to like a rhyme she learned or something. James is like, wow. I was like, here we go! They're in the whispering room and they realize people are gonna about to come find them. So James kisses her as a diversion and people walk in and they're like, oh, like, oops. They decide to kiss some more. They're like, surely someone must be coming. They start making out and Matthew finds them. I was like, Matthew, why did you take this moment? And I know he's heartbroken a little bit by it, but come on, come on. These two need to be together and it's just absolutely ridiculous it's taking this long. Oh my gosh, when they're about to go try to capture the manticore and the pixis thing, Magnus Bane shows up and Matthew loses his mind. And he's like, we could have tea. I'm a true enthusiast of your work, Mr. Bane. Also your personal style, your waistcoats alone. I just love it. And Magnus tells James like, hey, you know that sand you gave to Henry, he tested it and it's not from this world. As soon as he went into this other realm and realized that it had sand, my brain is immediately going back to Thule from TDA. And so like, is this the same world? Because like, are the Blackthorns connected to it somehow? Like, I have no idea, but I was like, it sounds similar to me. Like the setup of it, like the dunes and stuff, like it just sounded really similar. For a second, I was like, are we gonna have a, like one of those like mashups, like the Sweet Life of That's So Raven or whatever? Are we gonna see Clary? Because like, I remembered Clary seeing herself like in this world dead, but maybe before that. Or like, are we gonna meet up with our like regular time crew and like have all these timelines connect? We didn't. I think that would have been really, really difficult to do with this storyline. But for a second, I was like, are we gonna meet your great, 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 great grandbabies? No, false alarm. But Magnus is gonna help like cause this diversion while the kids get the manticore into the pyxis. They get it into there pretty easily. And Thomas even is like, that seemed a little bit easy. And then the box explodes and tells James to come with him. No, cause I thought he's so nice that he might sacrifice himself for the greater good and like go with this demon and meet his grandfather. And then during this fight, Cordelia falls into the Thames and like Lucy is freaking out because her future paramatai is drowning and she's calling for help. And like, she was calling for help from a boat, but because she can like order ghosts, all these dead bodies at the bottom of the river like raise up and like on the helm is like Jesse Blackthorne. And they bring Cordelia to safety. What is going on? Oh my gosh, we go back to the days passed when Cordelia gets Cortana, and we get to see that moment where Alistair's like, I'm the oldest boy, like when I get married, my last name's still gonna be Carstairs and yours isn't, and all this stuff. But like, Cordelia's been dreaming of having Cortana as her weapon since she was like a little baby. Their father actually gives Alistair the sword because he's like, you know what, like you have a good point, like this is a Carstairs sword, and Cordelia, when you get married, your last name isn't gonna be Carstairs. But then like, Cordelia like holds her hand out to it and it like Thor hammers into her hand. And their father's like, sometimes the sword chooses the bearer. The wand chooses the wizard, Mr. Potter. James is sitting alone in a room with Cordelia and Alistair comes in pissed off because he thinks that James is gonna try to ruin his sister's reputation because he hates Alistair. And James is like, I would never do that. Like, I can't believe you would think I would do that. And Cordelia like kind of tells James to leave because Alistair's gotten really angry. And he's like, I've done so much for this family. And then Cordelia's like, what did you mean by that? And apparently their father was drunk her entire childhood. So Alistair feels like he didn't have a childhood because he spent his whole childhood trying to protect Cordelia from finding out that her father was constantly sick because he was plastered all the time. And it's like all of a sudden she's seeing like her family life in this new light. And then we also find out what happened to Jesse, like how he died. His mother was too worried to give him runes. Like she didn't really even want him to be a Shadowhunter considering that her father and brother had died because of Shadowhunter stuff. So Jesse was like, either you're gonna give me the runes or I'm gonna go to an institute and get them. And so she was like, you know, I'd rather do that. So she gives him a rune. And he becomes one of those like forsaken children who die because they can't handle runes. So I'm wondering, if Jesse comes back to life and marries Lucy, is he going to be a Shadowhunter, or would it just be Lucy being a Shadowhunter person, but their kids would be Shadowhunters? Because he's still a Shadowhunter in theory, even though he can't bear marks. And he tells Lucy, like, I wasn't the one who called the command to save Cordelia. I thought you were in the river calling for help, and like, you can order ghosts around. And so I came to save you. And he's like, I would have given like my last breath, which is tucked in his little locket, for you. And she's like, I can't believe you would do that for me. I'm like, it's because he loves you. I'm like on board for this train. I'm pretty sure I'm right because there seems to be other evidence out there that they might get married later on. So Christopher gets hurt by a demon, and it's very like Hermione's been frozen by a basilisk type of moment, because like he was the one who was going to be able to make the antidote for all the people who had the poison, and now he's stuck with the Silent Brothers trying to get better. We find out that Cordelia's mother is pregnant, so there's going to be a baby in the next story. We get a message from Jem, but not really, it's a fake, saying to come to the Silent City. So James, Matthew, and Cordelia go. And during this time, James asks Cordelia, like, are you okay? Like, you and James, like, you aren't a thing. And she says that she's fine. And she's like, why do you care so much about me and not about your parabaton? And he's like, I don't know, but I find that I do care about, like, you. I cannot believe we are doing this again. We did this already.
In a frail device. We are not having another Jem Wiltessa situation, please.
Oh my gosh, it was so creepy when they're in the Silent City and they're like, Jem, where's Jem? He said for us not to talk to anybody, and we're here in the infirmary trying to find him. And then all the corpses, well, not corpses, all these injured, unconscious people start chanting his name, and I was like, oh my god. And then Ariadne is like, you have no other choice but to surrender to like this demon grandpa of yours. And then Jem shows up, he's like, what are you kids doing here? And they're like, you summoned us here. And he's like, no, I didn't, y'all need to go. And so they run away. But now James knows, like, all this fighting, like, even if we find an antidote, it's not going to stop, like, all these people getting hurt unless he goes and talks to Grandpa. Meanwhile, Thomas and Lucy have gone to the scary Lightwood Manor, where they're gonna try to find, like, this root that they need to finish the antidote that Christopher had started, because Thomas might know how to finish it. And Lucy wants to go in there. She's like, why do I always look out? She ends up, like, seeing something a little suspicious. And she goes over to this roofless storage shed and sees Grace talking to Jesse's body, which is in one of those clear coffins with his arms crossed like Snow White. Oh my gosh. And then behind her, this demon looms up and is like, Grace Blackthorne, you foolish girl. And he says, you should never have betrayed the oath your mother swore to those far more powerful than she. Some enchantments are not yours to remove, do you understand? And she said it had already begun to fade, it was not working. So, right below that, Lucy is like, she must be talking about the enchantments placed on Jesse. Jesse's fine, nothing's happened to Jesse. The enchantment that Grace removed was the bracelet that was on James. And now she's having to pay for it. Like, they're coming after Jesse because Grace broke that promise, and the demons are kind of like working with Tatiana to keep Jesse alive. So like, now she's having to pay the price for that. James goes into this scary demon portal realm and finds that his grandfather is one of the princes of hell, Belial. He admits that he held the demons back from London to make them all soft so that the Manticore would be able to injure everybody and, like, cause this mass panic. And Belial tells James that, like, yes, actually, I would really appreciate your body because I love being around humans, but I can't do it unless I'm in a human body, and I need yours because you have my blood. Because for him, like, going into Ariadne's body and, like, being her for a minute, he's like, she was burning up from the inside. Like, it can't be human unless it's, like, you or Tessa, who has the angel, Clockwork Angel, which was protecting her, or Lucy. So he didn't really want to be Lucy. He wanted to be James. Whenever Cordelia and Cortana are around James, it's the same effect as the Clockwork Angel on Tessa, which I think should tell us something, James. But Belial's like, let me use your body and I'll make this all stop. And I was like, oh my gosh, he's gonna do it. He's gonna let it happen. And he's gonna be possessed. And I don't know if anyone's gonna be able to tell. But we didn't. Oh my gosh, thank goodness. Like, James and Cordelia do have brains in their heads. Because, like, sometimes our Shadowhunter friends do things that don't even make sense. And these two, like, at least they make sense. And James is even like, no, it would not be worth it to have, like, this extra power to be immortal. Like, all the things you're offering me, like, no, I'm not gonna do it. And then all of a sudden, like, Lucy has this weird, almost parabatai feeling sort of thing about her brother. And is like, I need to go find James right now. Is it because they both have, like, demon blood that she can tell? She looks at Jesse and she's like, I command you to take me to where he was. And Jesse gets pissed about it, but he does it anyway. So James, who's in this demon realm, is attached by a rope to Matthew, like an everlasting gobstopper rope. And Matthew is pretty much getting flung against this brick wall of a demon realm that he can't go into, so Cordelia cuts him off and grabs the rope. And then is like, you know what, Cortana might be able to cut through this portal, and she does. And Cordelia ends up in this demon realm with James. I'm like, oh good, two of y'all are in here now. Cordelia essentially kills Belial while she's in there with Cortana, which should seem like, you know, a lot. And they were like, you know, that should take him out for the next 100 years. Like, we're good. And, but like at the end, we see him talking anyway. So I'm like, did he not die? Was he that powerful? Maybe he had his roots in another realm. So like, it wasn't like he was really killed. James and Cordelia come back out. Cordelia has broken her leg, but James is like on the brink of death. Matthew's there like feeling the parabatai ring. Like, you know how like, it feels like a cord like pulled taut about to be cut. And like, James can feel him dying. Like, none of the Arathis are working. He's like, he's leaving. And then Jesse shows up and he gives James his last breath. Alistair has this moment with Cordelia where he's like, the reason I bullied your friends in school was because it was either be bullied or bully other people. And he's like, which one would you have chosen? And Cordelia's like, if I had to choose, I wouldn't have chosen either one of them. I would have come home. And I think that shows that, you know, Cordelia's kind of a better person than her brother, but I think Alistair's gonna come around later. Grace shows up to James's room where he's recovering from almost dying. He's like, you know what, I don't wanna talk to her, but fine, she can come in. She says that she's sorry and she never wanted to do this to him. And she says, my mother made me her blade to cut every barrier raised against her. She puts the freaking bracelet back on him. And now he's like back in love with her, constantly doing whatever she wants. Right when we got Cordelia and James like almost together. And then she tells James, like, you need to go kill this thing that's in my house, that her mom is about to kill herself because she has found out that, you know, Jesse's last breath is gone and she has nothing to live for anymore. Like, screw Grace, I guess. Grace is like, my mom's gonna kill herself and then this thing is gonna come alive and kill all Shadowhunters, so you need to go take care of it. James is like, yeah, sure, now that I'm in love with you, like, let's just do that. And so he goes and he cuts up this big automaton thing and it explodes into fire. Cordelia and Matthew come to save him, and it's just such a mess. Matthew's like, you mean it blew up, like, while you were in there? This house blew up. We end up at this huge, like, all-clave meeting where even the kitties are allowed. Tatiana Blackthorne is freaking out because her house is burned down, and apparently, I guess, Grace talked her out of killing herself, and she's like, it was James, I know it was. And Cordelia is like, I'm not letting James go down like this. So she stands up, and she's like, James could not have been an Idris, because he was in my room all night long. And I was like, oh! She has ruined herself now in the eyes of society. No one's going to marry her because she spent the night with a boy. Except for James, who proposes. I know this is not how I wanted this to happen, but they're now gonna get married because he's like, you know what, we can get married. Like, that'll save you from shame if I marry you, because he was the one who ruined her even though he wasn't even there. Like, they're gonna be married for a year, and he's like, then we can get divorced. I can be with Grace. You can proceed with your ability to get married intact again. And I was like, oh my gosh, yes, they're gonna get married. Also, oh my gosh, no, why are you putting a year time span on it? Y'all are gonna fall in love. Cordelia's gonna take that bracelet off of you. Even when you were wearing it at the engagement party, I feel like later Cordelia is gonna crack and be like, James, I love you. Like, it bothers me so much that you're wearing that bracelet when we're about to get married. And she's gonna take it off. And he's gonna fall in love with her all over again. Will is so excited to have a new Carstairs in the family. He's like, yes, like, out of all the people, I hope it was you because you're a Carstairs. And Tess is like, that can't be the only reason you like our future daughter-in-law. The antidote has been made. All of our people are back. And Ariadne comes and finds Anna. And Anna's kind of, you know, stone cold now. She's like, never gonna fall in love. She refuses it. And Ariadne's like, I'm gonna make you fall in love with me. And this whole time, okay, so Matthew has never told anyone, like, the type of thing that Alistair used to say at school. And he always says, like, I can never forgive him because of what he said. And Matthew tells Thomas, who likes Alistair, he said that I'm a bastard child. He said that James is a demon child. Like, he said all these horrible things. And, like, the person that Matthew's mom supposedly cheated on Henry with is Thomas's father. And Thomas is, like, not gonna forgive Alistair for that. He is so upset by that. And I was like, oh my gosh, like, I forgot he said those things at Shadowhunter Academy to them. We're at the engagement party for James and Cordelia, and Magnus is there. He realizes how drunk Matthew is. He's realizing this pattern, and I think he's gonna help Matthew in the next one, because he even says, he's like, why do I fall into helping these people like Will Herondale and Matthew? So I think we're gonna get some help in the next book, which is gonna be really needed if Matthew's gonna fall in love with someone. It can't be Lucy because she's gonna be with Jesse, and it can't be Cordelia because she's gonna be with James. And I'm like, I'm so sorry. Can we get another person here? Another love interest. And you know, Cordelia is not happy at the end of this book. Like, she's happy to be marrying James. Like, that's what she wanted. She even says, she's like, I have everything I wanted. My father's coming back, but I didn't know he was a drunk. I'm engaged to James, but he's literally said he doesn't love you. Like, it's all the things she could have wanted in the worst way possible. We get this epilogue conversation between Belial and Tatiana. They have been working together because Tatiana needs Belial's help to bring back Jesse, and Belial wants James, so they've concocted this whole plan. Tatiana's like, why'd you let me get poisoned by your demon? He's like, to keep you undercover so people don't know. Now she's off to be an Iron Sister, and Belial is like, don't you see how good this is? No one can break into the Adamant Citadel, he said, but you will be escorted in, my dear, and then you will strike at the clay from its very heart. We will strike together. With her hand braced upon the coffin of her son, Tatiana began to smile. End of book. Oh my gosh. Okay, so we have to take down Tatiana immediately. And it's not gonna happen immediately, because she's gonna be at the Iron Sisters, where people are just like, assume all good things are happening. What did you think? I thought it was a 10 out of 10. It was so good. It was so captivating. I love learning more about our Shadowhunter series and our Shadowhunter world, and we get that every time we get a new book from Cassandra Clare, which I love. I can't believe we have to wait a year until the next one. This is the problem with staying on top of releases. Internal sobbing. What are your thoughts? How did you feel about Grace? Do you think she's part demon? Because she could be, right? Like, she could be an heir from Benedict Lightwood, because in theory he had sex with demons, and this could be another, you know, Tessa situation, except that Tessa's good and Grace is not. I just don't know who Matthew's gonna end up with. Are we gonna meet somebody new? I really want Matthew to have love in his life. Like this video if you liked it. If you want to talk about the next one when it comes out, please subscribe and we can do that, and it'll be so fun. I have a few other book reviews for other Cassandra Clare books, so please go check those out. My name's Caitlin. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!